nothing at all. I rise convinced that I'm bound to fall. This life and these dreams, it's so much harder than it seems.
Oh, brilliant. Charles James and the Rise and Elephants, a song representing Highland Radio and the talent competition or hero show, whatever. We have to call it something different next year because I can't get my head around that at all. But anyway, they're doing very well, and we wish them well, James and Catherine O'Donnell, representing Highland for the other 24 independent radio stations throughout the country. But sensational, I suppose, is one word to describe these people. Other people may call them something else, I don't know. But we say hello to Honor. Hello, everybody.
Oh, hello, how are you? How are you?
We're doing good. And Declan, hello to you, Declan, and Tom there, and Jermot and Dean. You are all very welcome. Say thanks for coming. I know you have been flat out, and we appreciate you calling up. The final bit of the contract was only signed last night, and we done well out of it, in fairness. Like, but come here. Who's going to just first of all, just for people that aren't too sure, as I say, it just seems to have taken off all of a sudden. You know, so Jermot, tell us about the beginning, how it all happened. Honor, you were four people, but you had different sort of connections to start with. You sung in duet, you sung as a duo.
Yeah.
And then this came over lockdown, am I right? Or?
Yeah, so, I mean, we all knew one another from the circuit around home.
Uh-huh.
Several of us had played in different kind of different variations of bands around the country in certain ways. And then lockdown hits, everyone's at home making videos and all the rest.
Aye.
And we said, sure, why don't... So Dean and myself were a duo before lockdown.
Uh-huh.
Tom and Declan were a duo.
Uh-huh.
And we said, look, let's put our collective talents together and make a video. Because at the time, everyone was... We were just out of lockdown, I think. So we went to Merva Forest in... up home.
Yeah.
In Ballantra. In Merva. Merva Forest in Merva.
And, is that just beside Merva Beach?
Yeah, how do you know? Yeah.
Oh, we've been there many of the time, let me tell you. Stop. We've reared it.
We went there one night, September. It was late September. We had made the Iron Triangle song.
Mm-hmm.
Hadn't released any of it. And made a music video. And I think like maybe less than 2 weeks after putting it up online, between all the different places, about 3 million people seen it.
That's
in about 10 days.
And how did you feel about that? Like, did you? Gee, you know, it seems
it was
phenomenal.
It was literally surreal because I actually posted the video at 5:30 that evening. I went to work at 6 o'clock, so I'm standing at work pulling pints. And about 8:30, there's a man in the hotel where I was working, was looking at the video on his phone, and he didn't know that it was.
You?
Me, I gave him a pint of Heineken and his wife had brought over the video to show him.
Aye.
And I was like, holy moly, what just happened? I didn't know this person. Like,
did you sit in him, did you?
I was like, that's me standing there. Yeah.
I
didn't mention any of these boys or anything, but
no watch about them boys.
Yeah, but that's how it took off. So we were standing there going, well, maybe we should keep this up.
Aye.
You know, if people are that into it.
Was it like a pure chance, would you put it down as this?
It was
getting
it was,
together, or was it?
I don't know. What do you think? Like, there was a page on.
It was the Hill 16 page.
Hill 16 was the name of it.
It was like a GAA page.
Aye.
That followed the Dublin GAA.
Aye.
And they shared it, and obviously Isle Triangle being a Dublin song.
Aye.
George will tell you all about it, I suppose.
Of course.
But it
took off from there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And were you amazed, Tom, how quickly it did? Like, you know, because I know for me and Jimmy's point of view, we were watching it. And we were, you're going, how come?
Well, it kind of did and it didn't. Like, we kind of sat on it for 2 years. We were a bit lazy with it.
Well, we didn't have a name until, like, it was the end of last year.
Yeah.
Because we had no Facebook page or anything to snowball from the Outer Triangle video. We had nothing.
And we'd never properly played a song together as a four-piece, like, just recorded. Up until just before Christmas last year.
Yeah.
But you see that video's done, like, your voices all gelled, you know, the four of you, and that, maybe that's part of it too, because it's unusual to get people that just gel with that, come out with that sound that you've created, you know what I mean? It doesn't happen a lot. It does happen, but they have to work on it. You just didn't seem to be...
We're kind of lucky in a sense that we've four very different voices.
Uh-huh.
You know, mine's is very harsh, Dermot's got a lovely tone of like Michael Bublé kind of a tone, and Dean's like, Dean could sing the phone book and it's
very good, you know, I like that one.
Myself and Declan be more from the rock influence, like
aye,
but the boys can, you know,
we're a lot softer, the two of us.
Honor, Honor, that's what? Honor.
Honor,
yeah. Honor, how did that name come about, or was there a reason for choosing that name?
I can't remember. I know we were all just kind of brainstorming, trying to find a name. I can't remember who came up with it or where it came from.
We wanted the name to be Irish.
Irish, yep.
Given the response to like the Irish song we had put out at that stage. And then last year we were like, we'll try to find an Irish word that represents it. And we just thought honour was a nice thing to hopefully aspire towards representing as a band.
Excellent.
The music business can be kind of... doesn't always get the best rep at times, so maybe if we have that as our name, we'll live up to it, hopefully, you know. Hopefully, maybe we should have said our name was Millions or something. Find Irish word for that.
Exactly. Right, well, first of all, we would we'd like to get a song, if you don't mind.
Yeah.
So, first song you're going to do for us is?
We're going to the Green Fields of France.
Brilliant. Whenever you're ready.
Sit here down by your graveside and rest for a while neath the warm summer sun. I've been walking all day and I'm nearly done. I can see by your gravestone you were only 19 when you joined the great fold.
The green fields of France. There's a warm summer breeze that makes red poppies dance. And look how it shines now from under a cloud. There's no gas, no barbed wire, there's no gunfire now. But here in this graveyard is still no man's land. The countless white crosses are mute in the sand. To man's blind indifference, to his fellow man. to a whole generation that were butchered and damned. Did they beat the drums slowly? Did they play the fight lowly? Did they sound the death march as they lowered you down? Did the band play the last chorus and chorus? And did the pipes play the flowers of the forest?
Oh, Willie McBride, I can't help but wonder why. Those that lie here know why. Did they die? Did they believe when they answered the call? Did they really believe that this war? They lowered you down. Did the band play the last Boston chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest? Did they beat the drums slowly? Did they play the fight lowly? Did they sound the death march as they lowered you down? Did the band play the last Boston chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest?
Yeah. Absolutely brilliant. Brilliant. Well done. That is Onor Institute. Hang on a second. There we are now. Thank you. That's Onor live in studio singing a classic. The Green Fields of France. Tell me, do you see when you're picking songs, do you sing, is it the older ballads that you're going for, or do you have a modern slant in there as well?
Well, there's a... When we started out with the ballads, it was all well and good, but building out a show for the upcoming gigs, we've kind of realised that no matter how much we all love ballads, everyone will be asleep. After 2 hours.
Very good.
So this has been a big kind of challenge for us at the minute, because we want to leave our wee thumbprint on everything that we do. And I think if we... Certain songs you would just end up copying and pasting them to do them.
Exactly.
So it has been a challenge. Dean's our arranger, so this man has the headache of figuring out all that madness. Okay. You know, the harmonies are his field. So it's kind of been a big challenge for you and all of us, really.
Yeah, it's tough trying to find songs that are up-tempo and... Yeah, things that we like and being able to put our own stamp on them as well.
We don't want people to come into the Baller or in Greenion and see something that they could see in McGinley's down the town, like,
exactly,
or Voodoo. Or
I get that, you know, definitely, Tom. Because you have something unique and you want to keep it that way. And as you say, Dermot, the ballads are all fine and dandy for a while, but after a while, people will be nodding off. You know what I mean? Fairness. But but you know, Dean obviously have this challenge and they come up with something, and is it like stripping back maybe modern songs? Is that what it's about, to the raw harmonies? And is that
that's definitely what we did with Mad World. I know it's down tempo as well, but we wanted to try and do something a lot different than, you know, an Irish song. So we were looking actually for a Christmas song, and we didn't want to do your kind of, you know,
standard
Fairy Tale New York or whatever. So we were kind of wrecking the reins. I was actually on holiday in Lanzarote and Mad World came on, and I remembered that that Gary Jules version had been released during around Christmas time. Aye. So I thought, why don't we try and do something like that with a kind of Simon and Garfunkel harmony kind of idea on it with an Irish instrument. And then Tom got in contact with Tara Howley and she played the Ellen pipes on it first.
Oh, that was amazing.
Yeah, it turned out really well.
It just... unbelievable. There were, you could feel it when you're listening to it, you know. And I remember Jimmy saying it to me, oh, God, I'm ready. It was just, it really, really was. Is Tara accompanying you on this gig?
She is in Ungrainal. Yeah, she's for the two Ungrainals.
So is it, the tour consists of, these sessions are in the Baller and three shows in the Baller and two in Ungrainal. Mm-hmm. And that's, they sold out all their shows online. Everything was online. Like, that's just, were you amazed at how quickly they sold out?
Yep.
I remember me and him, and we, was it Thursday night or was it one night only? And you know, you go on their webpage and you keep watching, you'd probably do the same.
Yeah.
And the next thing you refresh and the MC was going, you refresh, and that's the way it was going. You were going, it's mad. Yeah. You know,
it's crazy.
It's fantastic.
We didn't know we had so many friends and family. We didn't know we had so many friends and family.
We're hoping we have a lot more friends and family down the country as well. We can sell out there too.
Who's that from Scotland there, Jimmy? Maureen Grant says hi from Scotland.
Hello, Maureen.
And Darren Boot.
Darren
says, unreal to see the lads finally getting the recognition they deserve. Looking forward to the Valor shows. And Aidan Laird said, the harmonies are pure class. Great to hear these guys are selling out shows. Absolutely, Aidan. And Kathleen Bennett said, amazing. And Mary Bradley says, looking so forward to their concert. It was a real nightmare getting tickets. I know, Mary, it was.
Sorry, Mary.
But you got them, Mary. That's the main thing. You know what I mean? And Martina Patterson said, these boys are amazing. They were amazing on Friday night. Fair play to them. And so proud of Tom and all the boys in the north from Rushing, Thomas G and Dallin.
Hey. that's my family.
Oh, is it?
That's my wife and my three boys.
And am I saying that right, Dallin?
Dallin,
yeah. Lovely name. It's an unusual name.
Aye, it's actually a very old, it's an old Celtic name.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Lovely, first time I've heard that. So the Ungrainal and the Baller, what's after that?
We have the Ashland Centre in Kilcar on the 15th of June. That'll be our next one. I think the tickets are going on sale for that this week, actually, aren't they?
Where can they get them?
On the Eventbrite.
Eventbrite.
I think the tickets are going live. I was just chatting to John Byrne down in the Ashland Centre before we came on there. Mm-hmm. They're probably going live tomorrow, but we'll have to keep an eye on our Facebook page tomorrow morning.
So you heard it first here, folks. If you are looking for tickets, get on there right and early. And that's a beautiful setting down there. It's lovely. You know, it's...
Yeah, myself and Declan played a gig there during the summer with Declan Sinnott, and it was a lovely room to play.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you were down with Declan? They were up here that night, weren't they? They're up with you. They didn't want to come on with me. I remember that day. It was lovely. So after that, then, you know, going forward, obviously you're on to something here. Would you do songwriting? I know you are songwriters in your own way, but would you be?
I think all of us have.
Not something we've done together, but it's all something we've done individually. We're hoping after maybe on Greenon that we'll get a bit of time to kind of sit down together and get some stuff together. That's definitely the goal. We'd like to have our own stuff out there. Yeah, so.
We've got plenty of melodies and plenty of lyrics, but we just need to put...
Plenty of stories.
Put them all throw them good all into a bag. Yeah. Just, I know, it's good. But you were with Marty Morrissey and the Marty Party.
Ah, Marty.
And that was Saturday night.
Friday.
In the Clan Rhee.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But you remember a couple of gigs with him, are you?
We did. We did Limerick and we did Galway with him as well. So we did the University Concert Hall in Limerick and we did Leisureland in Galway.
How did you find that experience?
It was great. Yeah, it was great. It was great for us because we were doing the sound check and we were like, this is the first time we've actually performed together in a theatre or anything. So it was nice to get a wee run of things coming up to our own shows, kind of settle the nerves a bit.
And so the thing about your own shows, as you say, you were selling tickets and you hadn't performed live.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for the four of you together, that was something else too. Going, something here. And the video's done that, you know,
That was good to prove actually on Friday night that we could actually sing them live as well. It wasn't wasn't a bit of studio trickery. Yeah. We're not a
Vanilla,
is it?
very good. But have you something planned for the summer as in gigs or are you just early days?
What else have we got coming up? We're in Mary from Dunloe on the 3rd of August. We're doing the Thursday down there. We have Aaron Moore, which actually sold out as well, is at the end of August. And the Hawks.
Oh, we're going over to that, Jimmy, aren't we?
Yeah. No, brilliant.
Good. Oh, the Hawkswell in Sligo on the 14th of September, I think it is.
We're carrying your gear on that night, by the way. Just to clear up a few things, you know.
Take the boat home as well, yeah, first.
we're going down to Kerry as well.
That's right.
Kerry. Excellent. Yeah. And your connection, are you with the management or anything, or are you just on your own as such?
No, we're self-managed, and Jeremy's dad's actually helping us out at the moment, Sean.
Uh-huh.
Hello to Sean.
Hello, Sean.
So yeah, he's taking a bit of the load off us at the moment, but no, we're self-managed mostly.
There's no reason not to be, like, you know what I mean, because the products are yourself. Why give it to somebody else? Just do it yourself. So.
At the moment, it's kind of enjoyable doing it. It adds a lot. Now there will be hopefully a time where you want to focus more on this kind of stuff, the singing and all that.
Of course.
It's kind of enjoyable at the minute, you know.
Yeah, and everybody does something. Everybody has a little job there or something that they take care of. So kind of. It's not one person doing everything.
Yeah.
We'll get him onto the merch. Get the woolly hats.
We have somebody on it.
We have somebody on it.
Hey, Maria. Yeah.
Woolly hats, T-shirts, and key rings. Get them all out there. Absolutely. Oh, we're on. Absolutely class, lads. So great to hear such talent homegrown. You'll be in the arena before you know it. Best of luck. Joe Gibson. I have a song from Joe Gibson on the way very, very shortly too, by the way. And a good man, Joe. Keep her going. And amazing.
I was in college with Joe, actually.
Eh?
I was in university with Joe.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Went to college together.
He didn't do too well, did he?
He's doing all right.
Aye, but university-wise? No, I only Joe. They're doing very well. They're bringing the Fla here. He was telling me earlier on there. And is it? There's a new song. I just want to see where he wrote me. He said, the County Fla is taking place this year again in Letterkenny from the 9th to the 15th of May. And there'll be sessions all over the town. And so, listen, we're fair play to you, Joe. And we'll get a wee spin of this new track that he's got. Joe always coming up with great music. And fair that's what it's all about. And he's a hard worker
with the
music scene. Mm-hmm. So, right, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take an ad break and we're going to come back with another tune. Listening to Onor live on Highland Radio on Monday night sessions and streaming it live on highlandradio.com. Don't go away.
The choices we make determine where we're going. Where will your choices take you? Visit Kelly's Toyota, Letterkenny or Mount Charles and join the thousands of Irish drivers who swap diesel for Toyota Hybrid Electric, lowering their emissions and fuel costs. We've Ireland's widest hybrid electric range, including the Toyota CHR and Yaris Cross. Don't miss out. Order today at Kelly's Toyota, Letterkenny or Mount Charles. You'll never take a wrong turn with Toyota. Built for a better world.
Bluebird Care are looking for you. Bluebird Care are currently seeking carers and nurses to join their ever-expanding team. Immediate starts for carers in all parts of the county, especially Letterkenny, Inishowen and Donegal Town. Bluebird Care are also looking for registered general nurses for day and nighttime 12-hour shifts. Contact Bluebird Care on 074912 9562 or bluebirdcare.ie and bring care home.
Broadcasting throughout the Northwest and across the world online. This is Highland Radio with Paul McDevitt.
Well, you wake up in the morning, you hear the church bell ring, and they march you to the table. You're doing the same old thing. On the table, ain't no pork up in the pan. You better not complain, boy, you'll get in trouble with the man. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let it shine, let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me.
Let it shine.
Let the midnight special shine an ever-loving light on me.
Yonder come Mr. Rosie. How in the world do you know? By the way she wears her apron. She wore umbrella on her shoulder.
shine her ever-loving light on me. If you're ever in Houston, well, you better do it right. You better not gamble.
Dean, great finish there. Well, love that. Absolutely brilliant. It's Yundu Onor, live in studio this Monday night. That was taken from an album of 1969 by Creedence, John Fogerty and Creedence, called Woolly and the Poor Boys. That's that song came out of, just in case you ever asked, you know what I mean? That's where it came from, Woolly and the Poor Boys. Great album. Well, John Fogerty, of course, touring Ireland, or coming to Ireland, not touring Ireland. In the next month or so, I think it's something like that. Anyway. But anyway, going forward, or not even going forward, at the minute, do you concentrate solely on this project or do you do your own thing still?
We do our own thing still, yeah, until this takes over, hopefully. That's the plan, hopefully. Yeah, I still do the pub gigs. We do the weddings, me and Declan. Dean does the weddings as well.
You have to be keeping the money coming on, haven't you? To same time, right? Are you full time, Tom? Or are you?
I'm full time musician. Yeah.
You see, and the rest of you too.
Yeah.
Oh, well, then you need to be. Well, it'll not be long till you hit the big time, the millionaire stuff. You know what I mean? how did the Marty Morrissey connection come about? How did that happen?
Marty Morrissey got in contact with Colette. A lady called Colette from Donegal. I was like, what? I can't remember her second name. But anyway, he was looking for because Callaghan. That's it. Yeah. So he was looking for acts for the Donegal Marty Party, and she recommended him to us. And then he actually ended up knowing a neighbour of mine, and he contacted her to ask about us. So he is a neighbour of mine. He's actually from his hometown. They grew up together, so
excellent.
He got in contact with her as well. So yeah, then he right, he had us down on St Patrick's Day on the radio as well.
You were down,
RT, yeah. That's what nice.
He actually got her up on stage there.
That's right.
Last weekend, she was at the gig and he got her up and told that story to
the.
Yeah, Bridget
Breen.
Yeah, shout out to Bridget and to Colette. Thank you very much.
Excellent, excellent. And was it enjoyable?
Oh, yeah. It was great. We got a great reaction. Very happy.
It's great to see it and may it continue. As I was saying about ballads and songs and stuff like that, do you search for songs or do you have them just in your repertoire? You know, would you have them at hand, or do you look into deep into old songs that haven't been about for a while? And like, what I mean by that is, I love the ballads and I love the old songs being brought. You know, you always this fear of songs being lost in time, and I always think it's great to bring out. Do you just go far back to dig up songs, or do they just happen to songs that sort of resonate?
Tom was saying there, maybe last week, week before, like it'll be a real cool project whenever this is a bit calmer and we're not flat out preparing for the shows to even look at old Irish poetry and stuff. Yes, you know, like it'd be great to do something like that. Not a lot of people are at that anymore.
Exactly.
You know, give away our ideas. What are you doing?
But don't worry, nobody's going to do it like us.
Nobody does.
I'm not
worried about that. I know what you're saying.
And there's so many like artists that, you know, there's people nowadays, even modern people that are writing poetry, that probably you'd know them in the street and you don't know they do that.
Exactly.
It'd be so great to do something like that.
But you know what? Even somebody said to me the last night in Letterkenny, I haven't heard something like that since The Voice Squad. And to be honest, I've never heard of The Voice Squad. And I looked them up on Spotify on Saturday. And they're an old Celtic group, like...
From Ireland?
They're either Irish or Scottish. I haven't got the full history of them, but I mean, like, there's loads of stuff that nobody's, as you say, kept alive, like...
You know, I listened to Tommy Megan and Liam Clancy over the weekend, and there's so many great ballads, and you're going... There's nobody doing them. You know, are they going to be lost in time? I know maybe they're just not relevant all the time, but, you know, but I just, you feel the times, like, no, I don't.
There seems to be a bit of a folk revival, though, you know, the likes of George's band and ourselves, and, like, there seems to be a bit of a hunger for that kind of music again.
Good music. Yeah. Do you think the lockdown play a part in that, this whole thing? Do people now appreciating it more, a new appreciation of it?
I think so,
yeah. When you started, the four of you together, one of your videos, you know, when this lockdown project, were you in the one place when you started, or what way did it work for you?
We were just out of, the first lockdown had just been lifted, so it was during the lockdown where we sent a message over Facebook saying, lads, let's get together.
Mm-hmm.
Lockdown lifts, and then you were all up to my house, and I think we recorded the whole thing. It took 9.5 hours. Then I took the thing, went away with it. So we don't do that anymore. We take 9.5 weeks to make, you know, a song. But we just the one day landed early, left late, and then when we finally got around to being able to do the video, that night at midnight, the second lockdown was instated.
Yeah.
So by the time the video went up, we were back in lockdown. So lucky enough, we were all kind of around home, kind of. At a loss, like, so we were lucky that we had the time to do it.
Are you all in the one area, from the one area?
Within, 25 minutes of each other?
Right. Well, it's funny how that worked, isn't it? You know, you're really, with the second lockdown and stuff, you're really...
And if it had been normal times, I think everyone would have nearly, life would have taken over and we'd all been too busy to...
We had no plans to do it again. I think that seems
to be the good thing about this, Tom. It seems to be flowing naturally itself. The whole process seems to, I'm not saying taking off like mad, but it's really interesting to from our side to sit and watch what's happening here. But I just think
but even the show, you know, sorry to interrupt you, but,
no, you're all right.
The show was kind of more of us pressurizing ourselves into rehearsing more and stuff. We said if we book a show and we can fill 200 seats, there's an onus and there's a responsibility on us now to step up to the mark. And then you're looking, whatever it was, 8 minutes later, and you're like, oh God, what just happened?
And, you know, a week later, now we have five.
Yeah.
And we're done.
Yeah. There's a sort of reality kick in there, Dermot, as you go, wait a minute here. You're right, what you're saying. People will be.
There's 1,400 people now depending on us to be good.
But there's nothing like that pressure to kind of to get
you're
you
not happy. Dean will give you your money back.
Do you know something that these 1,400 people don't know yet?
But I think it has improved us as well. I think a lot, even doing the harmonies and stuff. I think when we go back to record again, we'll probably be a lot quicker.
It'll take
a lot less time. Than
when you were talking about the after the Owl Triangle, I remember the day we decided we'd do another one was the it was one Sunday. Actually, Daniel O'Donnell gave us a write up on his column.
He did. I remember Sunday Word. Yeah,
we said to Daniel, "There's something in this. Like, maybe we should do another one." Like, that's how we.
One a year. Yeah. It was one a year. We had one September 2020, 2021,
that's
and then
right.
2022.
Yeah, right.
So then we decided, right, we better run with this a bit.
Well, you see, when you have the like of Daniel O'Donnell noticing that, and all the people noticing it, and then, you know, say, for example, the Marty Morrissey show, this and Greening thing, do you say to yourself, there has to be something special here? Does it dawn on you to think that yourselves, or what really?
I think as us, we don't really look at it that way. I think what's really touching is that the outpouring of support from people locally, the likes of Noel Cunningham, the likes of Daniel, all those people, the support they've given us, it does make you stop and go,
Yourselves,
absolutely, yeah.
Oh, but it's quite easy for us because we were just amazed. And as I say, we were on this journey with you, believe it or not. You wouldn't have noticed us, but we were on.
And you're going to join, both of you are going to join us for the Ballor as well.
So. Aye.
When's that?
Jesus, you better put it in your diary. It's 2 weeks. The 16th is the first one, is it?
Yeah, so yeah. Sunday week.
Sunday week.
Oh, I can't wait for that one. When's it?
It's not the wife's birthday or anything.
No, it's my wedding anniversary, but it doesn't matter. I'm going out anyway. I'm here listening to Highland and watching the Spurs game with the lads from Lorcan McGarry. Good man,
yes, Lorcan.
And he said he wants to know, Lorcan wants to know, are they going to do a cover of the Ship Ship song?
Lorcan sent us a link to that, all right?
Did he?
That one might take a while to record, Lorcan.
Brilliant. You might join us.
Mary Bradley says, wishing them nothing but great success and honour for future in the entertainment business. Charlotte McGee said, fabulous and honour, amazing harmonies. And
Charlotte keeps us fed during our rehearsals and recording.
Oh, is that right?
Chairman's mum. She's a feeder.
Yeah,
excellent.
She makes a lovely dinner.
Audrey Lillis and Clancy. Hello, Audrey. She says, hi to everybody. And Tsunami. Oh, that's Paddy and them, Tsunami. Sounding great, lads. As was the warm-up snippet earlier. That's the one we had the rights to that one, don't we? Martin McFadden.
Yes, hey, Martin.
Good stuff, lads. And Dominic Breslin says, brilliant stuff, lads. Keep up the great work.
Dominic's in Sweden.
Is he? Yeah,
excellent.
Well, you see, they can watch us live.
There's
here.
Actually folks listening in from Switzerland as well.
Is there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. My aunt Valerie, she's the baker. She makes lemon drizzles for us. Yeah. She's listening from Switzerland tonight.
Is that where she lives?
She's out having a good time on holidays.
God, that's supposed to not have her. That's supposed to not have her.
Valerie's not listening.
Valerie was giving out about me.
That's
was
right.
Yeah. Was she?
She laid into Germany.
I didn't mention German. Was that? Yeah, you
did. He got in hot water.
Bring that over.
Yeah. No lemon drizzle.
Give that over Declan to hear what he has to
Valerie,
say.
Valerie, if you're listening there.
Here,
get it here.
I don't know how it come up, I wasn't friends with Dermot on Facebook at the time.
Okay.
And there was a tree, so I was tagging the three lads and I never tagged Dermot. Valerie sent me a private message.
Oh, yeah, she's got the back, yeah.
She's Dermot's biggest groupie. Like, yeah. He found the ball there.
Don't forget Dermot.
All the break.
He's the main man.
I'm not gonna get into Valerie's bad books. Oh, Jimmy, I'm mortified for you. Chairman's outstanding. The rest of them are all right there, aren't they? Oh, that's good. Where is she in Switzerland?
Yes, yeah, so my sister.
You're safe enough. We've security cameras here. We'll
know if she's out there.
There's a woman waving.
Actually, if she'd have been in Ireland, we probably would have had about five apple tarts up with us.
He's missed out, lads.
maybe the next time, Valerie. But no, it's all good, lads. That's really, really good. And we're delighted. For your success. And we genuinely hope, because it's great Donegal product. And it's, you know, you have a natural talent, and people aren't just booking tickets because they think you're white nice fellas, you know what I mean? They're booking tickets because they love the sound, and I think the future's going to be big, you know, really, really do. I don't think we'll get you back up here again. I don't think you should fall your heads. But we wish you well for that, and especially coming up this. I know, like, you have a fair old run there too from over and where is it again? Lahey, Ballantrae.
Donegal Town. Frost's, Mancharlis, and Ballantrae.
Down that way. Well, sure, that's great. We would love to get another song, if you don't mind.
Definitely.
You okay, Jimmy? This next song you're going to do first. Do you need to chin up or anything there, Declan? Are you all right there or not?
Aye.
I can take an ad break.
Aye,
yeah. Just to pay the rent here. Back at this break. Don't go away.
Super Value makes saving money as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, we match Aldi on the products you love. 2, great special offers like Super Value Fresh Irish Housekeeper's Cut, save 33%. Graham Norton Sauvignon Blanc, €10. And 3, money off vouchers every week on the app. So, follow the 1, 2, 3 and save money at Super Value. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Do you need a little extra help staying in your home? At Bluebird Care, we offer a wide variety of Qmark-approved personalised home care services across Donegal. And our fully trained and committed staff will always meet your care needs with kindness, compassion and dignity. To get your personal home care assessment plan, visit bluebirdcare.ie or call our care team today on 07491 29562 and bring care home.
Yes, welcome back. Highland Radio Monday Night Sessions. Microphones flying right left and centre here. And if you've just tuned in, it is the Monday Night Sessions. We have Onora in studio, and you can look back at it on highlandradio.com. We'll do that one after us later on. But they're going to do a final song. Anyway, listen, there are three gigs coming up in the three in the Baller and two and in Greenan. And there's no doubt you're genuinely looking forward to these and meeting and greeting and stuff like that.
Absolutely.
And we just want to wish you as well going forward and say thanks very much for coming up. We really, really appreciate it.
Thank you very much for having us. It's an absolute pleasure.
As soon as
Tom
was on the toilet, we'll get going again. Mary McGlynn said, come on, Tom. Don't panic, Tom.
Nature calls, boys.
Tom, when you gotta go, you gotta go. You wouldn't have run out in Marty Morris as quick, would you?
I would.
Mary McGlynn said, wishing the boys every success. Looking forward to seeing you in Angrenan.
Thank you, Mary.
So, sounding great, lads. From what have we got here? Oh, good luck, Tom and the boys from the Rush family in Castle Fun.
Oh, yeah. Stephanie's.
Aye. And Valerie here, coming over the Swiss Airwaves, clear and sound. Thank you very much. That's great, you know. At least Jimmy can go home safely. But the next night, Valerie, we won't want them apple tarts. We don't mind that stuff coming on, you know what I mean. You know? But we don't get a lot of it here, but anyway. Come here, this final track we're going to do, well, not final track, but this next song we're going to do is...
I'm going to do the Parting Glass.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah. Absolutely beautiful. And do you know, just before we go, do you know when you take on a song like that, say, like the Parting Glass, the Old Triangle, there's a responsibility there, isn't there, because of the history of the song and the many people that have recorded in the past. So there's pressure on there, like, to get it right.
I think Tom keeps us in check for that, because Tom, out of all of us, definitely has the deepest knowledge on folk music and Irish music.
Ah.
And there has been times where we've been a wee bit eccentric when we're recording, and Tom says, no, hold on, put it back.
Ah, you know? Very good.
And even at that, we put up the Old Triangle, and we would have got a bit of heat off people. That's natural, and none of us mind. It's kind of funny and it's enjoyable too. It means you're doing something right if someone's giving out, I think.
Uh-huh.
But a lot of them said, you know, it was too modern feeling or something. But we do try to be genuine and honest to it, and Tom keeps us in check there.
Well, constructive criticism, nothing else.
Yeah.
If it's any other, can you just block them?
Yeah.
Where'd you go?
That's Dean's job.
Set Valerie on them.
I tell you. But anyway, listen, the Parting Glass, this is an oar.
Of all the money that e'er I had, I spent it in good company. And of all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to number to me. For all I've done, for want of wit, to mend me now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you all. Sorry for my going away, and of all the sweethearts that e'er I loved, they would wish me one more day to stay. But since it fell unto my lord, softly call, good night and joy be with you all.
drink. I may not be drunk. A man may fight and not be slain. A man may could. All the pretty girls at last be welcome back again. But since it fell unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call good night. So fail to me the parting glass, drink a health whatever befalls.
So I'll
gently rise, softly call good night and joy be with you all. Good night and
me say absolutely brilliant. That is an oar on the parting glass. God, I could feel that. Can you see them hair in the back of my neck? Honest to God, lads, absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So well done.
Thank you.
And hang on, thanks for sharing your music with us. And I think it's going to be a massive year for you this year. Looking forward to seeing these guys in the Ballar Theatre. Wishing you every success from Avril McNamee. Thanks, Avril, for getting in touch. And we're delighted to say we're bringing in our next guest, and we're delighted. And this is what you call dedication. When someone, you know, drives off from Dublin just to have a chat to us, and we totally appreciate it. And it's one of the country's finest ballad singers, George Murphy. George, you're welcome.
Paul, I'm delighted to be here, but I didn't come up just to see you now. I mean, your sound and all, but you're...
I know that, George.
I decided to turn it into a bit of a week's holiday, so I'm up with the family, taking in all, right, all the beautiful sights around that account.
Anyway, that was George Murphy.
you're great to make me come across as the dedicated musician that tried to... she'd be at home saying, that's not true.
No. But listen, it's great to see you up here, and you're more than welcome. And do you know what? You probably picked a good week, because I don't think the weather gets too bad, you know. So.
Yeah, well, I picked a good week, but I'm not usually intimidated going on after absolutely brilliant.
Aren't they?
Incredible, lads. Really.
And you've been following these boys from the start, basically, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I came across Tom online during lockdown and stuff like that, and a few of his videos, a lot of videos of people, and reached out and asked Tom if he fancied being a special guest on one of my own shows at in the Ballar. But like, I should be supporting these lads now, not the other way around. You know what I mean? But delighted that Tom came on board, and then I seen he had joined up with these lads, and I seen a couple of their videos, and just gone from strength to strength.
Excellent.
Not surprised that they've sold out 5 nights now in between the Ballar and Green On, you know.
Online too.
Absolutely, yeah.
We're going to get a song, and you've graciously, I don't know who's graciously, well, you graciously joined them, or they've graciously let you join them, but you're going to do a song together, are you?
I think so, if that's all. Yeah,
we're going to do it.
Tom, don't be looking at me like that. That's the fear of God comes on me then, you know what I mean?
Now we're going to do a song from George's native county, the Earl Triangle. And he's happily going to do the fourth verse for us.
Awesome.
Ewan Quinn is on Twitter there, and he says, great show. Great show to Onor and everyone else. Marie Galvin, no, it's like your tweet, unofficial. No. Unofficial. It's different glasses I need. But anyway, listen, thanks to everybody who messaged in tonight. And
thank you.
Mary McGlynn said, George, see you on Saturday night.
Lovely Harlem.
There you go.
Mary.
There you go. Right, so do you need time to tune up?
Uh,
or he's good to go?
Lovely.
Usually people are good to go, they're, you know, at it for a while. Like, you know what I mean? But going ahead, when you're ready, the old triangle. This is Onor and George Murphy live.
A hungry feeling came o'er me stealing, and the mice were squealing in my prison cell, and the owl triangle went jingle.
Legends together as Onor and George Murphy. What a version that. Thank you very much. Where am I? There I'm there. Absolutely brilliant. Well done indeed. That was just amazing. Amazing. Murphy's Bar said, can't wait to host George and the Sons on Friday. What a pleasure. There you go.
Yeah, they're buzzing for that. But it's weird. Some of the gigs that we've been doing around are like stand-up concerts, like the Balor will be. And so be seated auditorium, kind of silence. And they're fantastic gigs to play them, but that gig that we're doing, like, they want us to do it like a session, like pints on the table, sitting around having the crack. And actually the girl that joined the Onor lads, Tara Howley,
yes,
I met her at the Late Late Show, so herself and her dad are coming up for that as well. So we're all just going to be lads. If you aren't doing anything on Friday, come on down to Murphy's. It's going to be great.
Sorry, Who?
Ollie's.
Oh, I don't know. I heard pints on the table. I went,
well, pints on the table. That'll do us.
Where am I, Jimmy? Darren Boot said, magic. Good man, Darren, again. And Martina Greer said, amazing as always, folks. And Maureen Rouse, hello, Maureen Staban. Maureen said, brilliant show. Loving this, Paul. I've been following George on Facebook. Brilliant band and best luck to them all. Thanks, Maureen. And Martin McFadden said, you're class, George. Kathy Kelly says, amazing, everyone. And Ada Laird said, just another level. Kevin said, class. And someone says, Paul, you are just something else. Them boys is okay. No, I just made that up. That was me texting myself. Brilliant show. Wishing them every success from Mary. Well done. Right. Listen, it's been an absolute pleasure having you, lads. I really, really genuinely mean that. And as I say, we just love the story so far. And
thanks for having us.
We hope you don't become prima donnas and all that. We'll carry on. You know what I mean? But I'm listening here to Highland and watching the sports game. And who is it again? Lorcan. Oh, he said they sounded unreal tonight. Ah, there you go, Lorcan. You want to go and hear them on the baller? Well, you can't if you haven't got a ticket. So no pressure. Do you know the dates offhand?
For the
Baller?
16th is the first, then the 22nd, 23rd?
Yeah. And then and Greenland's
the 25th and the 26th of May.
Yeah. Brilliant. We're looking forward to it. I really
and
are.
And Kilcarrow.
Ashland Centre, 15th of June.
And tickets will be going on sale probably tomorrow night. So watch out for that. If you want to get a brilliant gig, go along. And the Onor. Listen, Declan and Tom and Dermot and Dean, thank you very, very much. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much indeed. Here we go.
Do you suffer from high cholesterol, menopause symptoms, digestive issues?